Are you a designer who's never written a computer program but would love to do so? We're going to have our special guest chef, Veronica Ward, as a designer, teach you how she got started coding in the Cozy AI Kitchen. There are more designers learning how to code these days. Well, actually, they're having AI code for them. As a leader of this revolution, I want to invite Veronica Ward to the Cozy AI Kitchen. Welcome, Chef Ward.
Hello, nice to be here.
Thanks for being here, because Veronica has been learning how to code, but also coding with AI.
Yes.
And you're not a programmer by training.
Not at all. No, I would say I reluctantly code. I have a background in textile design, and I even used a typewriter in high school. It's not natural for me to code, but AI makes it very, very easy.
And do you think more designers will code with AI this way you're doing?
Absolutely, yeah. It makes it effortless. You don't really have to do much outside of copy and paste.
No. Well, let's see what happens. All right, Chef Ward, please take the kitchen stage.
Thank you. So I'm going to make a P5JS agent. And just for a little background on what P5JS is, it was a creative coding platform that made it very accessible for designers to learn how to code, which came out of the MIT Media Lab, which you know a few things about.
A little bit.
Yep. And so I can get into how I started to create it. I started with a model, and here I'm using GPT-4o. And the instructions. And the instructions are really where the meat of this is. And I used AI to create my instructions for me. I asked AI to create an agent for me that would be able to create beautiful P5JS creative code files.
You use the agent to prompt itself.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, interesting.
It made it much easier. Because if your instructions aren't right, your artwork might end up being a little funny.
And just a note for the audience here, this surface of Azure AI Foundry agents designed by Veronica.
Among others, but yes, yes, thank you. So in here, I am referencing other examples that I haven't done that were found on P5JS. That is what it's very, very good at, is having a number of examples. And I've referenced Perlin Noise and a recursive tree that was made by one of your former students, Dan Schiffman.
Yep.
And in the instructions at the very end, I ask it to spit out its code in one block, just to make it as easy as possible.
And this is easier for a designer to read than a program.
I think so, yeah. Code is a little bit hard for me to understand, but words are much easier, as are images. So you'll see in the knowledge source, I've added those.
What is knowledge source?
Knowledge source is what grounds your agent. And here I'll go to manage just to show what those are. And here's those three files that I reference in the instructions.
So grounding means it uses the information in those files?
Yeah, it means that it's using these as a source of truth so that it doesn't go too far off from its knowledge base.
It's like its library shelf.
Exactly, okay. Yeah. It just focuses the agent to get a better result in the end.
I like that, focuses the agent.
Yes, focuses. There's a number of other knowledge sources that you can use, but for what we're creating here, we don't need anything other than some example files.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just paste in a prompt that I have pre-written. I've asked it to create an elegant recursive tree with a slender trunk and thin wispy branches with leaves that are full and graceful.
Ooh, sounds delicious.
Just, yes. And the tree branches should move elegantly to the motion of the cursor.
Got it.
Naturally blowing in the wind, and that's where the Perlin noise will come
poetic.
In handy. Yes.
Yeah.
So we'll just hit enter to get a response.
Okay.
Wait a little bit.
Okay.
And then there we go.
It's printing the code for you.
Printing the code for us.
Huh. So it's like a 3D printer almost of code.
Kind of, yeah. Mm-hmm. And all we need to do is copy the code,
mm-hmm.
copy, and then go into a P5JS web browser, and then hit play.
Oh, ooh. Whoa, and the mouse is changing it.
The mouse is changing it. It's a little jerky. Uh-huh. I wouldn't say it's quite as elegant as I would like it to be. Uh-huh. But
and how would you make it more elegant? How would you tune it?
We could prompt it again. Yeah. We could say that we want the movements to be a bit smoother. Mm-hmm. Say, make the tree move.
So now you're adding to the prompt that you started out with.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And just to be festive, we can say make it look like a holiday tree.
And that's auto-completing for you, too. Not bad.
Mm. Makes it extra easy. Mm.
When you're doing this, do you think you're cheating?
A little bit, okay. Yes. I often think this is not coding. Some people out there think HTML isn't even coding. So technically, maybe to some, this isn't coding either. Depends on your perspective. Mm. But it makes it easy to create fun artwork, and that's what I like about it.
Lets you be creative.
Yes, exactly.
In a different way.
Exactly, mm. Yeah. It's a very different medium to be working with. See? Ooh. It's okay. A little smoother. Okay. I don't see a lot of Christmas effect to it, or holiday effect to it.
How cool.
But we could try prompting again to do something a little bit different, maybe to just make it green.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We can actually tell it to change the color now, you're saying?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Hmm. Make the tree green.
Oh. So now you're basically art directing the AI.
Exactly. Oh. Yes. You are your own CEO art director. Hmm.
Do you feel like powerful, like mwahahaha right now? Or?
I feel like an artist. Oh, yes. Okay. So you can get creative and a little messy, turn up the model temperature to make it even more creative.
Hey. Well, it's green now.
There we go. Okay. A little more festive.
Okay. So you're using this as an artist to be more computationally creative. You also use it to help your children as a parent?
Yes, yes. I help use it to plan Montessori-related activities for my twin boys. Two and a half-year-old boys that I enjoy planning Montessori activities, because Montessori is a more independent way of raising your kids, teaching them how to do things on their own through practical life skills.
And you have your agent do that?
I do, yes.
Let's see their agent.
Yeah. So I've given it the GPT-4o model, and then I've provided it with instructions, which I again used AI to create the instructions for me, and just found information online as well as my daycare for tips on activities that would help encourage independence.
For personal use?
Correct, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
So here's the knowledge store in here.
The bookshelf.
How you're focusing your agent, and I've grounded it in these particular PDFs.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And so I'll just describe that I have twin boys who are 2.5, and they get really messy. And well, one gets messy, the other is actually very clean. Polar opposites, even though they're identical. So I'm asking it to plan an activity that won't cause a mess.
Okay.
So we'll see what it comes up.
And you did this to save time?
Yes, because there's a lot of activities to scavenge through online, and sometimes I just want to see a quick, at-a-glance view of a few activities to get inspired for something that they might like. Hmm. So here's a few options. Walk the line activity. They do that at their daycare. They're pretty good at it. Color sorting, they're okay at. So that would be a good activity to improve on. Matching cards. Opening and closing containers, they have mastered that. Open and close everything. So some of these activities I'm finding aren't the best, so I'm gonna ask it a more specific question, knowing that my son Monty is needing to work on his fine motor skills. So I'm gonna ask it to find some fine motor skill activities for me.
So you can like, it gives you an overall thing, and you can like, again, narrow it.
Yes.
And you use this every week or something, or?
It depends on what I'm doing and the mm-hmm. activities. Yeah. During the holidays, I'm gonna use it a lot because I'll be home with them.
Give me activities, AI.
Yes. Let's see what we have.
Mm-hmm. It's like rolling the dice for knowledge.
Kind of, yeah. Mm-hmm. Scroll on up. Good thing it's at the bottom, it's showing me that it's referencing those knowledge sources. Uh-huh. So pegboard toy. I do not want to buy a pegboard, so I might not do that. But beading sounds like a good one. That's less messy, and that's something that they can work on with their fine motor skills. So I could maybe get a shoelace and some beads and have them work on that.
Oh, like macaroni and okay. Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Or just some puzzles.
You can also tell it like what materials you have on hand.
That's
it can probably
yes.
coordinate that. Okay, right. Well, Veronica, you've shown us how as a designer artist, you're coding, and you're showing us as a mother, you're raising your kids in the Montessori method. Do you have any messages for our audience out there that's struggling with the same kind of issues, whether time or not having time to be more creative in code? Do you have any advice for young Veronica Wards out there?
Don't be afraid to get your hands a little dirty in some code. You'll learn a lot, and you will come up with a lot of new creative ideas along the way. I use it myself to help raise my kids, and I think it does a pretty good job planning activities for them.
Well, that's Veronica Ward, folks. Thank you so much, Chef Ward, coming to Cozy AI Kitchen. Stay tuned for the next Cozy AI Kitchen out there, everyone. Bye.